Good afternoon to all of you. The technology used to estimate intraocular pressure has evolved tremendously. IOP estimation by tactile assessment is the simplest and the easiest way to perform tonometry. Unfortunately, the IOP estimation is notoriously unreliable in most of the cases. This slide depicts the classification of tonometers. In routine clinical practice, we are interested only in the indirect method of tonometry. The two basic types of clinical tonometers differ according to the shape of deformation of the globe that is produced by the tonometer. It is a truncated cone with indentation tonometry and a simple flattening with applanation tonometry. Coming back to the classification, the most commonly used applanation tonometers can be of two types, the non-contact types and the contact types. The contact types are further differentiated on the basis of the variable that is measured. Fixed area variable force tonometers measure the force that is required to applanate a standard area of the condyle surface. The prototype is the Goldman applanation tonometer. Fixed force variable force tonometers measure the area of the cornea that is flattened by a known force. The prototype is the Maklakoff tonometer. And there are some tonometers that are a hybrid of applanation and indentation tonometers. The prototype is the Mackey-Mark tonometer. And there are still some other tonometers that do not depend on indentation or applanation principles. The prototype is the DCT. The Shire's tonometer is cumbersome as the patient needs to assume a supine position, but it is affordable, robust, and has no complicated electronics. Therefore, it is suitable for screenings, especially in low resource and remote settings. The Shire's tonometer does not make as precise measurements as other types of tonometers, as the measurements are influenced by a number of factors. Impact tonometry, also called rebound tonometry, in which a lightweight magnetic probe in an enclosed shaft is propelled towards the cornea and the rebound characteristics of the probe are measured, has shown quite promise. The Goldman applanation tonometer is based on the Imbert-Fick law. GATT uses an ablating force to flatten a constant area of 7.35 millimeters square. At this selected area, the forces of tear surface tension pulling the tonometer tip towards the eye and the corneal elasticity pushing the tip towards pushing the tip away are almost equal and opposite. When the tip of the bioprism approximates the cornea, the bioprism splits the circle of contact into two semicircles. If the two semicircles are properly aligned, they undergo a rhythmic movement in response to the cardiac cycle. The tension knob is rotated until the inner borders of the fluorescein rings touch each other at the midpoint of their pulsations. Factors such as central corneal thickness, corneal biomechanical factors, inappropriate amounts of fluorescein dye, pressure applied on the eyelids, Valsalva maneuver, breath holding, and high astigmatism can all affect the accuracy of measurements taken with the GATT. The Perkins tonometer uses the same principle as GATT, but is portable and can be used in any position. The commonly used NCT is an applanation tonometer which uses a column of air to flatten the non-anesthetized cornea. The advantages of the NCT include its non-contact nature, and it does not require topical anesthesia or instillation of fluorescein dye. The TonoPen is an electronic portable version of the Mackey-Mark tonometer. It is particularly useful for irregular corneas as the area of applanation is small, about 2.36 millimeters square. The pneumotonometer measures IOP by calculating the force required to flatten an area of cornea using an elastic membrane inflated with gas or air. Pneumotonometry provides reasonably accurate IOP readings across the range of corneal thicknesses and corneal pathology. Additionally, it can be used against the sclera near the limbus with IOP results nearly identical to those achieved by corneal contact. Recently, instruments have been developed that measure IOP through the eyelid over the sclera, obviating the need for topical anesthesia and the risk of eye-to-eye transfer of infection. While these instruments generally are not accurate enough for regular clinical use, they may have some value in approximating IOP when ornithotonometry is not possible, such as with corneal prosthesis and totally scarred corneas. GATT is the gold standard, and it is a well-accepted fact also that significant errors in GATT IOP measurements are mostly related to patient variability in the corneal biomechanical factors. These limitations of GATT have spurred researchers to develop alternatives. The ocular response analyzer uses a rapid air pulse to record two applanation pressures. One applanation pressure is recorded while the cornea is moving inwards during applanation, and the second is measured while the cornea is moving outwards while recovering from applanation. The average of the two gives Goldman-corrected IOP, and the difference gives corneal hysteresis. In the dynamic contour tonometer, the tip of the probe matches the contour of the cornea, and this approach eliminates the influences of the corneal biomechanical factors. The instrument measures IOP in both diastolic and systolic phases of the cardiac cycle, and the difference in the two is called the ocular pulse amplitude. The Corvus ST is a novel device that employs non-contact, bidirectional air puff applanation and also provides a corneal compensated IOP measurement. No single tonometer is accurate or usable in all situations, in conditions like gas-filled eyes, over soft contact lenses, corneal pathologies, keratoconus, and post-laser refractive eyes. The pneumotonometer and the tonopen are particularly useful. In addition, the DCT gives reliable measurements in keratoconus and post-laser refractive eyes. In eyes with corneal prosthesis, transpalpebral tonometers are useful devices, and when these are not available, one has to depend only on tactile assessment. Measuring pressure in children is not easy. For this special group, the Perkins, the NCT, and the rebound tonometers are particularly useful. Despite the many limitations, it can still be argued that the Goldman applanation tonometer remains the gold standard for IOP measurement. The GATT is the reference standard due to its historical use in most clinical practice and the extensive publications on its validity, reliability, and reproducibility. Most eye practitioners like the GATT because it is easy to understand the mechanism and principles of GATT as compared to the new tonometers like the DCT or ORA, which are much more complicated. New tonometers must agree with GATT to check the accuracy of the readings. GATT is familiar, comfortable, and less stressful to use than to change to a new tonometer. The economic argument is the strongest in favor of GATT. It is relatively cheap compared to other high-tech instruments. So my take-home message, no single tonometer is accurate or usable in all situations. Most new technologies for measuring IOP fail to measure up to the GATT. Despite the many, despite the Goldman's limitations, it remains the gold standard for IOP measurement. The important point is not to change techniques when you're following an individual patient.